And my dear students, this is Vikram Reddy, working as school assistant arts in ZPSS Kusmanchi, Khammam district. So for few classes we shall discuss about the topic atmosphere. Today we shall discuss one of the important concept, structure of the atmosphere. Before getting into lesson, I will ask you a easy and simple question. Try to answer it. What is the reason for life on the earth? I know you are familiar with the answer. Oxygen is the reason for life on the earth. Where from we are getting oxygen? For this also you know the answer. We are getting oxygen from the atmosphere. As we know, we breathe in oxygen and we breathe out carbon dioxide. We get oxygen from atmosphere. So we can say that atmosphere is the main cause for life on the earth. Not only giving oxygen, the atmosphere also preventing harmful rays of sun from reaching us. The plants, the green plants, take in carbon dioxide which present in atmosphere, and they release oxygen, and so the atmosphere consists of oxygen and carbon dioxide also. So atmosphere by providing life gas, lifeline for human beings, and it helping for the existence of life in many ways. For example, the winds in atmosphere, they transport, they convert the converted water in oceans into water vapor. The winds transport the water vapor into atmosphere, and the atmosphere convert for the condensation of water again in the form of rain. The winds transported into the continents. That means we are getting rains with the help of with the process that happened in atmosphere. And another example, we can say the winds of atmosphere are causing for the erosion of rocks. Erosion of rocks by winds will take millions of years. So due to erosion of rocks, the rocks will break into small pieces. Afterwards they will be divided into small dust particles. So with that dust particles, they lead to the formation of soils. So these soils are helping us in growing of different kinds of crops. That means we are getting food. So indirectly, the atmosphere is becoming cause for the existence of life or existence of human being on the earth. So we shall discuss what is the atmosphere. So it is the gas, a sea of gases surrounding the earth. Means the atmosphere is an area, or we can say that a thin layer that surrounded the earth. You can observe here, this is the thin layer surrounding the earth. This is earth, and this is atmosphere. So atmosphere is a thin layer surrounding the earth. Thin layer means the thickness of the atmosphere is 1000 kilometers. When compared with the earth, the thickness of the atmosphere is very less. It is 1000 kilometers. The thickness of the earth is 6000 kilometers. So we can say important, what is atmosphere? Means the atmosphere is a layer which surrounded the thin layer which surrounded the earth. So what are the components of atmosphere? So as we discussed and as we know, we already learnt atmosphere consists of oxygen and carbon dioxide. So not only oxygen and carbon dioxide, the atmosphere is composed of many gases. So automatically atmosphere has the characteristics of gases. The atmosphere compresses and also expands. Like that of gases, the atmosphere has no shape. For example, if you take a cycle tube, when we send some air, it will turn into the shape of cycle tube. So in that way, atmosphere consists of lots of gases. Particularly the main gases that prevail in atmosphere, life gas, that is oxygen, in the total atmospheric gases, the share of oxygen is 21%, but the major share is of nitrogen. Nitrogen consists of 78% of total atmosphere. The next one, carbon dioxide, around 0.03%. It is a very less percentage. Apart from these important gases, the atmosphere also consists of argon, neon, methane, ozone, and some other gases in very small percentage. So we can measure part of the atmosphere is full of gases. So including these gases, atmosphere also, it consists of mainly water vapor. It occupied about 0.4% in the total area of atmosphere. But the water vapor is close to the surface of the earth. Particularly, it is within the 6 kilometers above the earth. As we know, water vapor, the water which is stored in oceans and other water bodies will turn into vapor and it reaches the atmosphere. So that's why the water vapor is accumulated near the earth's surface, that is within the 6 kilometers radius. So it also, the atmosphere also includes dust particles. They are called particulates. They come from sand storms, which take place in deserts. So the sand particles, and when natural fires occurs in forests, those particulars, they include the in atmosphere. So these dust particles are called particulates. These particulates, they existed in atmosphere, are causing for both positive and some negative their impacts. These particulates are causing for the visibility of sunrise and sunset in orange color. Particularly in the early morning and in the late evening, we can observe the sun in orange color. So for that visibility, the particulates which are in atmosphere are the main cause for this visibility in orange color. And the particulates are cause for the occurrence of hailstones during rains. So these phenomena, this will happen in atmosphere. So next we shall discuss some important concepts about the structure of the atmosphere. So basically, atmosphere, as we discussed, it is a thin layer which consists of around 1000 kilometers of thickness. So atmosphere, on the basis of composition of different chemicals and gases, it is broadly divided into two layers. One is homosphere, second one is heterosphere, where the homosphere is called because the area in which it consists homogeneous elements, and where the atmosphere consists of heterogeneous elements, the area, the layer is called as heterosphere. You can observe some of the important layers where we can observe the different activities happened in the atmosphere, planes, parachutes. You can observe spacecrafts, satellites, the Mount Everest, which is up to 8.8 kilometers. So the meteors, polar lights, these consisted in the different levels. So we shall discuss it into deep. The first layer is homosphere. The homosphere, basically this was divided as it consists of homogeneous elements. Homosphere extend up to a height of 90 kilometers from the surface of the earth. For example, you can observe here from the surface of the earth, the homosphere is extended up to 90 kilometers, but the distance is different. The view of the researchers and scientists, they divided the exact area in different aspects. But this is the homosphere extended up to the height of about 90 kilometers. Again, the homosphere is divided into three important layers, as the layers are composed of the basic and important gases like nitrogen, oxygen, argon, and carbon dioxide. So, as the composition of these gases, the homosphere again internally divided into three important layers: troposphere, stratosphere, and mesosphere. You can observe here the first and lowermost layer of the homosphere was troposphere, next one stratosphere, and the third one is mesosphere. Troposphere, it is the lowermost layer of the atmosphere from the earth's surface. The average height of the troposphere is 13 kilometers. It is not equal in all areas. Near North Pole and South Pole, the thickness of troposphere is 8 kilometers. Next, in near equator, its height is 18 kilometers. So on an average, the height of troposphere is 13 kilometers. This sphere contains about 75% of the total gases of atmosphere. 75% of total gases of atmosphere they contain in troposphere itself. Next, what are the important activities take place in troposphere? It also contains all the moisture and dirt dust particles. I told particulates. They all exist in the troposphere. Next, water vapor, moisture, and these all accumulate in the troposphere. Entire weather phenomena, that means as we know, the water evaporation, condensation, that means water vapor turned into water droplets, and precipitation, water droplets reaching earth's surface in the form of rainfall, snow, and this precipitation, and severe cyclones, they occur. These all are called as weather phenomena, and this occurs in this particular layer. And another important change that take place in troposphere was that is that the temperature decreases as we go higher altitude from the earth's surface. When we are going to higher altitude heights, the temperatures will decrease. This decreasing of temperature is called normal lapse rate. In troposphere, the temperatures decrease while we are going heights. On an average, the temperature will decrease 0.6 degrees centigrade per 100 meters. That is called as normal lapse rate. That's why in high places, particularly in mountain areas. For example, if you take Ooty, Kodaikanal, Shimla, Kashmir, in the locations which are existed on the mountain ranges, there the temperatures are very low. So the people visits these places during summer because there the temperatures are low. That was because while we are going upwards, the temperatures will decrease at the rate of 0.6 degrees centigrade per 100 meters. So that is called as normal lapse rate. And the weather phenomena, evaporation, condensation, precipitation, you all discussed in concepts in 7th class. So this phenomena happens in the troposphere itself. Next important one after troposphere, stratosphere. It extends from the end of troposphere up to 50 kilometers height. And the specialty of this stratosphere is this particular layer is free from clouds. So automatically this is because why this sphere is free from clouds means the all the weather phenomena, turning of water vapor, water droplets, these all weather phenomena took place in troposphere. So that's why stratosphere is free from the clouds. So this phenomena is ideal for flying of jet aircrafts, because as the area is free from clouds, it is easy for the flying of jet aircrafts. So jet aircrafts fly in stratosphere, that means above the troposphere, that is after 18 kilometers. Next, another important thing in the stratosphere is it consists of ozone layer. As we know, ozone layer is protecting us from reaching of dangerous ultraviolet rays to the Earth's surface. The ozone layer is preventing us from the global warming. So, and another important phenomena was that in stratosphere, temperature increases as we go higher altitude. You must remember that in troposphere, as we are going higher altitude, as we are going high places, the temperature decreases. But in stratosphere, temperature increases at higher altitudes. Next, third one, mesosphere. After stratosphere, we have mesosphere. It is from the height of extends up to the height of 80 kilometers. So meteorites burn up as they enter this layer. As we know in Telugu, ulkalu, they burn up after they enter into this layer. Next, the temperature, change of temperature. It is reverse in like a troposphere. Temperature starts decreasing with the increase in altitude. So no important activities take place in mesosphere. Next, second one, heterosphere. We discussed about the three important layers of the homosphere. Next, we are discussing about the second broad layer of atmosphere, heterosphere. Because it consists of the heterogeneous elements, what we don't know much about those elements, so that's why the sphere is called as heterosphere. The heterosphere the starts from 90 kilometers, the layer above 90 kilometers is called as heterosphere. It has heterogeneous composition, means the researchers are going on, the scientists did not find out much about the composition of elements in the heterosphere. So that's why they are called as heterogeneous components or elements. So it is called as heterosphere. Again, it is divided into two important layers. One is thermosphere or ionosphere, and the next one is exosphere. First one is thermosphere. It extends from 90 kilometers and up to 400 kilometers. And the temperature, it reverses, it rises rapidly with increase in height. While we are going high places, height places, the temperature increases. Next, another important thing in this thermosphere is it contains electrically charged particles, which are called as ions. So ions contains in thermosphere. They have electrical energy. That is why it is also called as ionosphere. As thermosphere contains ions, it is also called as ionosphere. Next important one, the radio waves, which helps in operation of what we call radios and other use in these waves, communication waves. The radio waves are transmitted from the earth. They reached up to thermosphere and they are reflected back to the earth by these ions due to this electrical energy of these ions. So the radioactive waves will be reflected again towards the earth. That is the one of the important change take place in this thermosphere. Next, exosphere, which is at present at the high altitude of the, means it is at the end of the atmosphere, uppermost layer of the atmosphere, but it is above the 400 kilometers above the atmosphere. But researches on this layer are in progress. We don't know much about this exosphere, but the layer above the 400 kilometers is exosphere. So we shall discuss, we discussed important things. First one is importance of, try to recapitulate these important concepts. So importance of atmosphere, the role of atmosphere in the existence of life on the earth. Next one is structure of atmosphere. What are the important components existed in atmosphere? As we discussed, atmosphere consists of different gases, water vapor, dust particles, and those all. Layers in homosphere, try to recapitulate. The homosphere consists of three important layers: troposphere, stratosphere, and mesosphere. Layers in heterosphere, they are thermosphere or ionosphere, and exosphere are the important two layers in heterosphere. Next, the important layer of the atmosphere is troposphere. All the weather phenomena takes place in the troposphere, that is evaporation, water evaporation, condensation, precipitation. This all takes place in troposphere, dust particles, and these all consist in troposphere. Ozone layer. Ozone layer, as we know, ozone layer contains in stratosphere. Ozone layer is the important layer that is the cause for the existence of life on the earth. Ozone layer is protecting or preventing ultraviolet rays from reaching us, and it is preventing the global warming. So these are the important layers of the earth. So in the today's class, we discussed about the structure of the atmosphere and the important layers of the atmosphere. So you try to recapitulate these all things and go through the textbooks, textbook once, and answer the questions that existed in the textbook. So with this, I will conclude today's lesson.